We are meeting, of course, the banking committee. We're doing this virtually by Zoom. We are still in the pandemic, and I give my condolences and prayers to all of us, especially to those who have suffered from this tragic illness. We're dealing with two different pandemics, but we will discuss the banking issue, the issues that bring us here. Is there any initial comment that the ranker wants to make before we begin our meeting?
No, thank you.
All right. Well, then let us begin with this agenda. Ivan, would you be kind enough to... Ivan Young is my legislative director, and he's going to take us through the different bills. Ivan, why don't you, first things first, let's speak and say who's here. Why don't you say who is on this conference line so that people will know?
Sure. So on the conference line, we have Senator Kevin Thomas, Senator Timothy Kennedy, Senator Brian Benjamin, Senator Roxanne Prasad, Senator Neil Breslin, Senator George Borrello, Senator Daphne Jordan, and we do have the ranker on the phone, Senator O'Mara, and we do have Stanley De La Cruz.
Thank you very much. Why don't we begin with the bills, sir?
Sure. So the first bill on the agenda is 1476B. Sponsor is Senator Hoylman, and this is an act to direct the Department of Financial Services to study, evaluate, and make recommendations concerning lending practices by financial institutions to landlords acquiring property that includes small business tenants and or rent-regulated tenants.
Are there questions, comments, or statements on the bill?
What? Yes, not, I have a question. I have a question, Senator O'Mara here. And
a pleasure.
What is the conduct that we're seeking to have reviewed and potentially further regulated here?
Would you be kind enough, Mr. Young?
Yes.
So this is Elizabeth Nowicki from the Majority Counsel's office speaking. My understanding is that Senator Hoylman is trying to address situations whereby borrowers borrow money from financial institutions, use that money to purchase buildings with rent-stabilized tenants or small business tenants, and then use tactics to get those tenants to leave so that the borrower, now the building owner, can raise the rents. So DFS would be looking at a variety of foundational issues that would tend to promote that type of borrowing and lending.
Senator, was your question answered?
I guess so.
Okay. Are there any further questions, comments, or statements on this? If not, I'll entertain a motion.
Move the bill.
Second. You have seen who said?
Senator Borrello made a motion to move the bill.
Second, Benjamin.
By Benjamin. So I will, my disembodied self says that this bill has been moved, and you can tell us the rest of that bill.
Well, Senator Benjamin is not a member of the committee, sir. Although he has to talk about a bill that's on the committee agenda.
I forgot. Sorry.
Give me a second.
I'm happy.
That's a good point. I'm just trying to be helpful here, Senator Sanders. I apologize. I'll keep quiet. I'll keep quiet until I'm called upon. Let me go on.
No, don't be quiet, sir. It's Senator Benjamin is so ubiquitous that I not only is he president sometimes, I thought he was an honorary member of all committees, voting member. However, we have a second. I believe there was one.
Yeah, Senator Thomas here.
Senator Thomas is a second, sir.
Okay, who is a member of the committee? All in favor of this bill, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed?
Nay.
You are recording this, Mr. Young.
Senator Jordan opposed, but the motion passed. It's been reported out of committee.
O'Mara without rec. Right.
And O'Mara as well is a no.
Without rec.
Without rec, sir. Without rec.
Yes.
Without recommendation, sir.
Now, The next bill with
out of committee.
The next bill is 4652, which is sponsored by Sanders. It's an act to amend the banking law in relation to including information concerning repayment of outstanding loans in a standard financial aid award letter.
He always does smart things. Is there a question, comment, or statement on this bill?
Move the bill.
Second.
We have a motion by Senator Thomas, second by Senator Jordan.
All in favor of moving this bill?
Aye.
Say aye.
Aye.
All opposed? All without rec.
All right. The bill has been reported. Now, the next bill.
All right.
The next bill on the agenda is 5470B, sponsored by Senator Thomas. This is an act to amend the financial services law in relation to requiring certain providers that extend specific terms of commercial financing to recipient to disclose certain information about the offer to the recipient.
May I speak on the
Senator
bill?
Senator Thomas. Of course,
Senator Thomas would like to speak.
I believe that's Senator Thomas.
Thomas, no, that's Senator Borrello.
From where I sit, they sound so alike. Senator Borrello, why don't we have Senator Thomas explain it first, and then he may answer your question.
Yes.
All right. Thank you so much. All right. So the reason why I introduced this bill is because non-bank online lenders are the mainstream alternative providers to financing small businesses, right? And these online lenders vary significantly in the type of information presented to the customer. So what this bill asks them to do is make terminology standard so customers who are not really sophisticated get all the information they need to make an informed decision. So what this bill says is, all right, there's going to be a disclosure box with the total cost of capital, the term, payment frequency, APR, average payment amount, basic information about prepayment. This information presented as a standard format would be very useful for product comparisons. All right, so that's basically the crux of the bill.
Thank you, sir. Senator Borrello, I believe.
Yes, thank you, Mr. Chairman. I understand the intent of this bill, but as I've said before, as a small business owner, and is that we often in this committee try to treat commercial vehicles the same as we treat, things that are geared toward consumer loans. And it also, once again, we are looking at state chartered institutions that are only they'll be applied to in this case, and it's going to create a situation where they are unfairly competing. And there was a number of issues that were brought forth on this bill, technical issues that I think create unintended loopholes. You've got some language that wasn't really clear on things that I think is going to create issues for a lot of folks, including those that are going to be negatively impacted. But the bottom line is that fast, flexible loans for small businesses are critically important. I can tell you that. When you start talking about doing things that are going to include, for example, disclosure calculations requirements that are not accurately reflecting the true cost of financing, I think it creates an unfair level of competition, particularly with those non-state chartered institutions. There was use of the word double dipping in this legislation, which doesn't really have a definition. I think I understand what it means, but it's really not a technical legal definition. And there were a lot of other issues that were brought forth by organizations like PayPal and the Small Business Finance Association that I don't think were addressed. So while I agree with the intent, make sure people are informed, I don't want to see people misinformed, and I certainly don't want to see more state chartered institutions forced out of New York because of a different standard than those that are federally chartered or chartered in other states. So that's why I respectfully am voting no.
So to a number of those issues that Senator Borrello brought up, the technicalities in the bill, not even the trade associations who are experts could agree on certain definitions there. So once this moves, you know, we're going to have, some negotiations with DFS, and we'll go from there. But again, given that we are going through this pandemic, right? A lot of small businesses, like yourself, I mean, you're a former small business owner, you probably still are. It's imperative that you get back on your feet. And in order to do that, I mean, Sandra, you are probably one of the most sophisticated business owners, but there are mom and pop owners out there that just don't understand what the different like jargon is, you know, if they go to one lender online and then try to compare what another lender is offering, we need that kind of standard language. And that's what this bill does. I mean, with the technicalities, we can work on that. But the true intention of this bill is to make sure that our business owners get back on their feet and they're well informed when they sign off on that extension of credit.
Again, I think we agree on that. I think what you're going to do is you're going to reduce the number of credit opportunities because of the way this is drafted. And that's my concern, because right now, because of the pandemic, I can tell you that many business owners are tapping into whatever credit they can get. Their lines of credit are tapped out in most cases. They're trying to get federal assistance. Not everyone is getting it. The state's really offered zero assistance to our small businesses, unfortunately. So I think it's important that we, before we start doing things that impede our ability to get credit as small business owners, we should definitely try to do something to help them first. That's why I'm fundamentally opposed to this. But I appreciate the intent, Senator Thomas. And also, just want to point out that in the chairman's defense, you and I do sound very similar on the phone. So I think
yes, I mean, we are parking lot neighbors. So parking space.
I considered a victim when I'm there before you, by the way.
Yeah.
I'm glad that my PE credentials are still intact. PC rather credentials are still intact, and I certainly appreciate that. As I have appreciated the conversations, worthy points on both sides. Are there any more questions, comments, or concerns from anyone else?
I'll move the bell.
If this is not. Kennedy moves. Is there a second?
Senator Thomas, second.
All right. Well, you said Senator Borrello, second. All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay.
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 All without rec. Okay,
me.
I'll slow it down.
I'm without rec, and it's really for all the reasons that Senator Borrello spelled out. I hope some of those definitions are clarified and that you can work it out. The goal is admirable.
Well put. You have your numbers, Mr. Young?
Yes, sir. The bill passed committee. They reported out of committee.
All right. Thank you. Thank you all. Let's go to the next bill.
All right. The next bill on the agenda is 8721. Sponsor is Senator Comrie. And it's an act to direct the New York State Department of Financial Services and the New York State Department of State Consumer Protection Division to conduct a study on consumer awareness and financial education in New York State and to make recommendations for consumer awareness and financial education program.
Any questions, comments, or statements on this bill? I'll entertain a motion.
I'll move the bill. It's Kennedy.
Second.
Kennedy moves.
So we have a motion by Senator Kennedy, second by Senator Breslin.
All in favor, say aye.
Aye.
All opposed, say nay.
Nay.
All without rec.
AWR.
All right, so this bill has been reported out of committee. The next bill on the agenda is 8722, sponsored by Senator Benjamin, who is currently on the line as well. And this is an act to amend the banking law in relation to prohibiting state chartered banking institutions from investing in and providing financing for private prisons.
Senator Benjamin, before you are allowed to speak, would you mind asking to join the committee next time that you want to do this, sir?
I'm still in the fight, Senator Sanders, so I'll definitely make sure that happens.
Well, I appreciate it. Senator Benjamin, is there anything that you want to say on this bill?
Yeah, first of all, thank you, Mr. Chairman, for bringing this bill to the floor. You know, for me, incarceration is a necessary public function that is unfortunate, but it's something that has to occur. And as far as I'm concerned, it should be done publicly. You should not have private prisons and the profit motive involved in incarceration. So for me, this bill effectively states that while we don't have private prisons here in New York State, we don't want any financing of private prisons as well. This bill applies to New York State. I know my original bill applied for state chartered banks in New York, and they're lending all over the country, and this has been tailored to be a New York-based decision. We do have a federal prison in Queens, and so this bill would ensure that can't happen. And quite frankly, you know, I am I'm very interested in stopping the process of us facilitating the financing of private prisons. And so this bill is near and dear to my heart. And so I just wanted to stop. Well, actually, the chairman asked me to come. So I wanted to just come and let folks know why this bill is here and its purpose.
Before I find out if there's any other questions, comments, or statements, we do have a private prison in our district. It's in my district with my luck. As a council member, I fought for several years trying to stop it. It's three blocks from people's homes. A clear and present danger. So I had no tools. There was no law that I could appeal to or things of that nature. So I certainly see why this is important, and I certainly support it. Are there any other questions, comments, or statements from anyone else?
Yes, from me. But this bill only applies to state chartered banks. So wouldn't federally chartered and foreign banks still be able to let the money into the state for private prisons?
We only can control what we can control. I mean, if I had the power to do that, I'd do that too, Senator Jordan. But we can't control federally chartered banks. But any bank that is chartered in the state, and there are a number of banks who are chartered in the state that are impacted here. Now, as you might be aware, last year, Chase, Bank of America, Wells Fargo, and a couple of federally chartered banks made their own sort of determinations that they would stop lending to private prisons. But the goal here was to do what we could as a state to send a clear message that we don't want this happening on any level. But I would love to have a federal bill, companion bill to this as well. That would make me very excited.
I guess the problem that I see is that you're penalizing, in a sense, the state chartered banks when a foreign or federal bank could still come in and give the loan.
Yeah, I don't necessarily. I understand that. I've heard this. I heard that argument before. I don't, you know, I do believe it's important that New York is a first mover on this. I do think other states will do it as well, and hopefully we'll have a federal government that will do this also. I don't. I hear the point you're referencing, but I don't think this is a big enough business. We're not talking about lending to retail businesses here, right? Private prisons are not a major industry of U.S. commerce, but it's an industry that I believe shouldn't be happening, and so I think it's not going to cause major economic strain to our state chartered banks to have this, just given the scale of private prisons, particularly in New York State.
Thank you for your comment.
Thank you. Are there any other questions, comments, or statements? If not, then I will. I suspect that's Kennedy again.
I second.
So we have a motion. We have a second, Senator.
Okay. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay.
Nay.
All without rec, please say that also.
So this bill been reported out of committee, sir.
All right. You have the count.
Yes, I do.
Good. Then move to the next bill.
The last bill on the agenda is 8761, Senator Sanders' bill, and it's an act to amend the banking law in relation to modifying delinquent home loans and single point of contact.
Smart fella, that Sanders. question, comments, or statements?
Okay.
Move the bill.
I have a motion.
It has been moved.
Second.
Is there a second?
Second by Senator Thomas.
All right. All in favor say aye.
Aye.
All opposed say nay.
Nay.
All in favor of the negative.
This bill be reported without rec. All right.
This bill be reported out of committee. Ladies, sir. That concludes the agenda.
Ladies and gentlemen, I apologize for being unable to be there virtually. By you seeing me, I was unable to plug in for whatever reason. However, I assure you, and I'm sure that you all agree with me, I've never looked better. Now, this could not suit me. So having said that, I want to thank everyone for coming to this committee, and this committee meeting is now adjourned.